holiness, holiness, it's what I long for. Holiness, it's what I.
Hello, God's family. Welcome to Daily Rhema on AGTV. Moment with your General Superintendent, Stephen Yenusom Wengam. Today, I exhort you on the topic purification for holiness. Purification for holiness. My foundation text, 1 Peter 1, 15 and 16. What does the word of God say? But as he who called you is holy, you also be holy in all your conduct. Because it is written, be holy for I am holy. I will touch on three main areas. The call for purification to be holy like God. The call for purification to be holy like God. Number two, the conditions necessary for purification so as to be holy like God. And then thirdly, the crown you will earn when you purify yourselves to become holy like God. In verses 15 and 16, Peter calls upon the believer to be holy. Reason, because God is holy. Because we came out of God. We were created in God's image once you are born again. So if God is holy, how can somebody who came out of God, how can somebody who lives in God be unholy? So Peter calls upon us that because one, God is holy. Two, we came out of God. Three, you are God. Psalm 2 verse 8, he says, ye are gods. We carry God's DNA, God's image is in us. And therefore, we have no other option than to be holy. The conditions necessary for purification. What must I do to purify myself to be holy? Number one, you must be saved by Christ's death and his word. Saved by Christ's death and his word. Let's look at 1 Peter 1, 18 to verse 18 to 20, and then verse 23. What does the word of God say? I read. Knowing that you were not redeemed with corruptible things like silver or gold from your aimless conduct received by tradition from your fathers, but with the precious blood of Christ as of a lamb without blemish and without spot. So the Bible says when we are saved by the blood of Jesus, then the blood of Christ cleanses us and makes us holy. You cannot be holy if you have not had an encounter with the blood of Jesus. Number two, non-conformity to the passions of your past life. When you divorce yourself from your past life, your life of sin. 1 Peter 1, 14 and 15. What does the word of God say? And I read, as obedient children, not conforming yourself to the former lust, as in your ignorance, but as he who called you is holy, you also be holy. So when you don't conform to your former life of drinking, smoking, womanizing, bitterness, jealousy, name it, clubbing, stealing, corruption, then you are purifying yourself to be holy like God. Three, perfecting obedience in Christ Jesus. When your obedience is perfect in Christ Jesus. 1 Peter 1 verse 14. What does the word of God say? As obedient children, not conforming yourself to the former lusts. As obedient children, obeying God's word. Hallelujah. 22, 23 of 1 Peter chapter 1. Since you have purified your souls in obeying the truth through the Spirit in sincere love of the brethren. On two occasions in 1 Peter 1, he talks about obedience. Obedience to God's word, obedience to authority and rules also purifies your soul. Then number four, walking in the fear of God. 1 Peter 1 verse 17. How do I purify myself to be holy like God? Verse 17 I read, and if you call on the Father, who without partiality judges according to each one's work, conduct yourself throughout the time of your stay here in fear. Conduct yourself in fear. What type of fear? The fear of the Lord. Fearing God. When you fear God, certainly You purify yourself to become holy like God. Dearly beloved, I urge you to purify yourself to be holy. I choose purification for holiness. Holiness for revival. I love you. See you same time tomorrow. God bless you.